Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Shafika binti Ayu. I'm here to talk about my work titled Numerical Construction of Deformation Field in a Converging Channel. So in this work, we deal with granular materials. So what is the granular materials? Granular material is a collection of distinct macroscopic particles. So granular materials arise in almost every aspect of our lives, including many familiar materials such as coffee, sugar, sand, gravels, and powders. They are easy to figure, but they exhibit complex behavior that we cannot classify them as a solids, fluid, or gases. So a precise knowledge of how they behave under this circumstance is essential for the efficient design and applications of related industries. The predictions of the stress distribution and the flow patterns throughout the hoppers, bin, silos, or any related equipment is exceptionally very important. Storage, handling, and granular processing are procedures required in numerous industries and are of interest to various science and technologies branch such as physics, chemistry, agriculture, and engineering. So we develop the algorithm of the numerical method to construct the deformation of the granular flow. So we use the MATLAB software to calculate the solutions, and it then plots the data points and displays data graphically for the stress and the velocity field. This algorithm was then applied to the extrusion problem, which is one of the most common process in food manufacturing processing. So extrusion is a deformation process in which the granular materials are fed into the feed hopper, as you can see in figure 3, flow through the channel, then force through a die at the discharge end of the channel. As the food emerges under the pressure from the die, it expands to the final shape. So for the method, we begin by solving the governing equation using the method of characteristic. Then we develop the algorithm to construct each deforming region by applying 4 elementary stress boundary value problems. And then we use MATLAB to calculate the solutions, and it then plots the data points and display data graphically for the stress and velocity field. Now we start to construct the stress distribution in the deformation region under the wedge die surface AB. So we could see in figure 4, we assume that initial values for coordinates x, y and the stress variable angle psi and pressure p are known and constant at each point on AB. From the initial guess, we define the stress field in region ABC. So this gives an alpha characteristic AC and beta characteristic BC. We then construct two centered field regions, which is ACD and BCE, with angle theta 4 and theta 5 respectively from the known AC and BC. Now, when the fence have been constructed, the two known characteristics, the alpha characteristic CE and beta characteristic CD, intersecting at point C, which determine the stress field in region DCEF. Due to the symmetrical configuration, we consider the solution in the upper half of the channel. Okay, so the plastic field in the channel now entirely constructed, as we can see in figure 4. Okay, so as we can see in figure 4, at point F, the value of psi F is equal to 0, and the characteristic line at point F must incline at 60 degrees to the center line MN, since the deforming region must cover the whole width of the channel for the material to flow. Since we have determined the network of the characteristic lines and the stress distribution in the deformation region, we could define the corresponding velocity distribution. So we start to construct the velocity field in region DCEF. So from the below, the left side of the material ADF moves as a rigid body, so the normal component of velocity V alpha is constant along the straight line ED. Similarly, the normal component of velocity V alpha along the straight line BE is also also prostate. So therefore, by using the same method as for the stress field, the velocity obtained in the whole deformation region in the converging channel. Okay, so now to test the accuracy, we substitute the value of stress variables, P and psi, and the corresponding value of velocity, V alpha and V beta, into the work rate equation. And we obtain the positive values that prove the admissibility of the stress and the corresponding velocity. So this result is consistent with the findings of past studies by Hill, who considered metal plasticity. This consistency shows a good agreement with the result of the present study. So with this method, we could prevent loss in production, extra labor, plant downtime, poor quality control, and unreliable processing with properly designed equipment. So with this algorithm, it is useful in technical handling and troubleshooting the equipment, which can reduce equipment maintenance cost. Okay, so this computational algorithm is very useful for approximating the deformation for the flow of granular materials. And this method also is very useful in designing equipment and structures, such as in granular transportation and storage. So, in conclusion, the numerical approximation to the solution for the deformation and flow of granular material discussed have been constructed and give very useful insight into the flow of granular materials. So, thank you for listening. Assalamualaikum.